Hello everyone, and welcome to another Let's Play of This War of Mine. My name is Anna Mardal. This is day 59. Now, when we last left off, a lot of stuff actually had started happening. To start with, it's winter, and I can no longer use the water filters, rain filters. So we got about 60 good days out of that, and now it's over. We've already bartered for the day, which he's still at the door. I should send him home. Just because it's cold outside. And to double check that we've already bartered for the day. I've slept since the last video. Yes, we've got all the things we need from him. Although I wouldn't necessarily mind buying those filters off of him. Cigarettes. And maybe the books. No, he doesn't want to sell the books. I feel very protective of the books between you and me because I'm slightly afraid that somebody's going to burn them, and that's probably a silly fear to have, but I always get really sad when I think about how in times of a crisis, well, that's why I didn't make more food, because I want the water to be available. So right now, I still didn't tell him to leave. I'm just inconsiderate. Time to go. I'll try to visit you again. Thank you, Franco. So, let's have Amelia digging snowflakes. I always feel a little sad that in times of danger and hardship, the books often don't make it out, unscathed. So I kind of have this urge, however silly it might be, to collect the books when and where I can get them cheaply, because otherwise who will save the books? And I know that's silly. Let me find out really quick. We could build another cook stove for 10. I would like to put one maybe by the front door. That's not an option. My thought was that we could have another cook stove just for melting water, that wouldn't. Okay, so we can put one down here. Or potentially up by the furnace. Or over here? No, those aren't options. Let's put it in. What is that? It kind of looks like a shelled out bathroom. Whenever you have food on the stove, nobody can be making water. And I use a lot of water in non-cooking situations. So I really hate to feel like I have to keep the stove free of food just so I can be making water, if that makes sense. It would also be interesting to learn if there's a difference in the amount of fuel needed to make water at an unupgraded cook station than an upgraded one. So this is research for science. So one for four water for 1.4 hours. 1-1-1-4.4. 1-1-1-4.4. So okay, so this is a better cooktop because we upgraded it, but you can make water just as easily on the unupgraded one. So what I really want right now is for Katia and Zlata to stop being sleepy so that they can. Good girl, right on time. so they can be making water and firewood for us. We are gonna make it. That's all our firewood. As long as nobody, you know, dies of cold or whatever, we have, I think, enough food to make it now to the ceasefire on the, day 80. Because that's 11 days, and we've got 11 days worth of food. No, wait, it's 21 days. Never mind. I can't do math. It's tragic, really. You could be making firewood there. Ah. And Zada. I really want to know what happens if you make a snowman. Like, is it helping their emotions? Or I just want to know. I never could get one in the previous game because I didn't have enough time and everybody was sick. Like, right now. For, poor Roman is wounded from getting shot at the brothel where we hit a bug. It was not our fault we got shot. Okay. Speaking of the brothel, so Roman's gonna sleep because he's wounded. Amelia's gonna guard him. Zlata is gonna guard him. And Kadi is gonna scavenge. And we are going to strip this place to the bone. I don't remember if we still need saw blades or crowbars, so I'm not going to take any, so my hands won't be full. And I mean it. This place is going to be empty by the time we're done with it. We saved the women that were being held captive. And now it's just our chance to scavenge the heck out of it. And from a role-playing perspective, I'm actually really glad that it started snowing, because I feel like people will be less likely to come out for the services that were being sold here. And notice that we shot the place up. I would prefer not to receive consequences for that. I mean, realistically, you completely shoot up a brothel, and I feel like a lot of the customers that were using it would potentially come after you for that. But it's snowing now, so maybe fewer people will notice and they won't know how to track us. That's my role-playing headcanon. I like to make little stories while I'm playing. Which is why it really irked me, again from a role-playing perspective, that I couldn't tell that they were holding people captive here, because I really don't know how I was supposed to tell. And certainly it's just not good enough to be like, well, a brothel's evil or whatever. No, that's ridiculous. Don't. Alright. This is another big place, like the construction area was a big place, but I feel like we can break it down. Let's make a secondary drop pile here so we don't have to keep running back to the front. In those tiny places, like the shell department or whatever, it makes perfect sense to just have one drop pile because everything's so close to the exit, you might as well. But we've learned through trial and error that these big places really need a secondary pile, so we're gonna have one of those. Feel a little bit safer with that gun, although I don't think I have bullets for it, so probably not very safe at all. I feel that we saved everybody because we did save everybody. I feel that we killed all the bad guys because when we saved the girls and they ran out, there was no resistance or, you know, yells for them to stop. I'm slightly scared though, because I thought the wiki said that there were more people here. So either I misread or I miscounted the dead bodies, or maybe he left after we killed all his friends. Which I feel would be an intelligent response to having all your friends killed. I thought I already opened this door. That's kind of alarming. I think it's interesting game design that some things do still change while you're going about your daily life, because obviously people are coming and going and doing their own thing just like you're doing yours. And so you have cases like with the supermarket where apparently those piles that you see people looting are being looted by those people, which is cool, albeit a little frustrating if you want the good things. But sometimes it's not clear. What changes during the day and what doesn't. Band-Aid's good. We might use those on Roman if he's not doing better. I'm really worried about him being wounded during winter, because that's a bad time to be wounded. It's harder for your body to fight infection and get healthy and stuff when it's cold. We want gun would be nice, bullets, parts would be nice, food obviously, water absolutely, sugar, and then materials, because we actually are kind of low on those, and run to the exit. That's not the direction I would have had to take, sweetheart, but that's cool too. Off we go. Katia is back. Day 60, here we are. I found plenty of really fine stuff. What a night. Good girl. Night was calm. So I think fewer people are gonna try to... Diary, patched up and ready to go. Does that mean Roman's all better? He's slightly wounded. I think... My father and sister were shot dead. Some ragtag militiamen entered the house, claiming they were looking for enemy informants. They took my father and sister to the garden and shot them. The neighbors said they didn't even bother to interrogate anyone. Instead, they cleaned the house of anything valuable. Oh, is that why she's so shell-shocked? Sweetheart. So all the girls want to sleep, and Roman doesn't because he slept all night. I'm going to do something I would not have done at the beginning of the game, of this game, and I'm going to bandage him even though he's only, quote-unquote, slightly wounded. I don't want him getting worse this close to the finish line, so to speak. And plus, I need him working today. I can't have him lying in bed. Mei's tired. Zada's tired. Kati's tired. Once they get rested up. Oh, gosh dang it. Alright. Roman, we're gonna go down in waves of checking everything per floor. Check the radio first. Temperatures are still low, and besieged poker and firewood is getting harder to come by, and people are burning, gathering anything that can be burned. There are shortages of water throughout the city. If you melt snow for water, make sure to boil it before drinking. People are scouring the streets and abandoned houses for everything that can be eaten, burned, or traded. If aid doesn't reach the city soon, the situation will become dire. Okay, that's for making water, which right now, I don't know if I have the snowflakes for. I don't have the firewood for. Okay, understood. We're gonna pick up the harvest and we're gonna make another one. So we can get that going again. We could do with some bandages. You're already bandaged up, baby. So 61 divided by 4 comes out to, and rounded down because that's not clean, comes out to 15. So we have 15 days of food and another 2 on the stove because we've got 8 bowls of stew. That would get us to 70, day 77. And then we could potentially starve the last little bit. Because you don't starve to death the first missed meal. So that would get us to day 80. So we have enough food. It'll be tight. And I would obviously like to keep growing and catching more. But, you know, if the worst happens, we'll make it. Okay, can't use the filter. I don't know if I have enough water to use the moonshine still. Do I? Oh, I need more water. No, I need more firewood is what I need. Well, lucky for you, I was planning on making some of that. So we'll get a couple more firewood. We'll get the still going because that's barterable. Two of those, please. Is everybody done sleeping? You are. Glad I have this book. Alright, you get to be on the alcohol. Katia, you get to be on the herb bench. Amelia, you get to be making firewood. And Roman, you get to go to bed. Because you're still wounded. Alcohol. We would need fire. Okay, so we get to wait for... Turns out Amelia's gonna be on the alcohol distiller. So somebody should maybe take an axe with them to the brothel. And honestly, I'm really excited about the fact that I really do think we're gonna make it. And not just make it, I think we're going to make it in relative luxury, to be honest. So that's awesome. We need more wood. I'm going to wait for that. Medicines, and now we're gonna make some bandages. And Slotta's gotten us firewood. Amelia's gonna get us some pure alcohol. Alright, everybody's working really good down there. Whoops. I need to be careful where I click. But yes, I think somebody should take a axe with them and get some kindling tonight. Might as well. Alright, Katia. I would like you on snowflake duty, please. And let's just get... well, let's get as many as you can. Zlata's snowman lies sadly neglected. Maybe tomorrow. How many minutes can she get in? The snowman is important to me, y'all. I'm not gonna lie about that. Okay, we're not gonna finish the alcohol or the snowflakes. Alright, so off to the brothel. Zlata, you get to sleep. Emilio, you guard. Roman, you sleep in bed. Katia, you scavenge. Off to the brothel. And here's a nice, yummy hatchet to take with you. So let's do a quick look-see of the downstairs. Because there's probably stuff to hatch it up. There is. I wonder if we could not spend the remaining 20 days just scavenging this sucker. It is huge. So nervous. And you know what we haven't done this game? We haven't gone to go to the military outpost to trade with the soldiers. Which, frankly, I'm perfectly okay with considering that they shot me last time. I will never get over the fact that they shot Katia. She was completely unarmed. And she's a nice, good girl. Just look at her. And they just shot her. Without any kind of provocation. I will never not be upset about that. Okay. Probably shooting at some people right now. That's probably what we're hearing. Okay. People can't get any kindling. There's no wood. And I'm like, well, clearly they need to shoot up a brothel. Terraport all the furniture. I don't know, is it hypocritical of me that I want to save all the books, but I'm totally okay with, like, bashing in an ancient 18th century armoire. Probably is, actually. I know less about armoires than I do about books. And I'm a writer, not an armoire builder, so possibly I respect my own craft more than I respect others, and that's not necessarily right. I apologize to any armoire builders in the audience. Believe me, I would not chop up your furniture unless it was absolutely necessary. I would go through the particle board stuff first. glad we had that confession. Kind of funny how there's a bullet count up there, but if you're not carrying a weapon, it doesn't really. I guess it's still good to have. Okay, how close are we cutting? Not too bad, it's 1:30. We've got time. The hatcheting takes a little bit longer, makes everything take a little longer. So, do we have everything in this bedroom? Yes, we do now. So everything on the, what is this, the second level? It's the second level above the basement. I need to find a good way to designate it. I know they're not here, but it's just, who is being shot at? That's the question. That was the only thing I didn't like about the sniper junction place, was that it was like, I don't know, is it realistic that he would have an infinite number of bullets to just shoot at people constantly? Maybe it is. I guess that's kind of the point of the war game, that there's a million bullets, but there's almost no food. Like, when you find one canned food for one person for one day, it's a big deal. But bullets are like, yeah, got a lot of those. Okay, so, but I wanted to be thorough. So, everything except the woody ruins of that table I chopped up, everything on the second floor and up have been scavenged. I'm actually gonna leave my axe here so I don't have to bring it back tomorrow. Okay. Kindling, obviously. Leave the cigarette and get the pills. And let's leave the fake, or the fake medical, let's leave the bullet parts and get the pills. And we'll come back and get the hatchet tomorrow. Floor 6. Okay, yeah, it's the second floor where everything's pink. Everything in the first section and everything from the second floor up is empty. Why is it easier for me to start high and go low than it is for me to start low and go high? I don't know. Day 61. How is everybody feeling? I had a really good haul. Look what I got. Okay. Calm again. Good. I guess people aren't as likely to sleep. Did you sleep on the ground? All right, Cotty, you get to go up to bed. I would appreciate it if you ran, because I bet it's possible that Franco might come today. Sleep. I don't think you have if you slept poorly. There's no time to lounge. Okay. I'm not gonna make you. Well, actually, I would have made you, but let's go down here.
you change? No change. So, Zata. Oh, look at all that water. Let's start with... Zata, you get to go outside and work on the snowman, because I really do want to get that finished. I want to see what it looks like. Maybe we'll get status updates. I slept restlessly most of the time. Why did you sleep restlessly, baby? Is it just because it was cold? I don't sleep so great when I'm cold either. Roman's almost done. Those two are still sleeping. I think it's funny that you can build a thermometer in like an hour, but it takes all day to build a snowman. Roman, you can have one cigarette and then we're gonna have to go back to work. I'm sorry. We're lucky it's not cold in here. Alright, that's all the cigarette you get. I'm sorry. We're gonna make it. Alright, nothing to do on the second floor. On the third floor... Well, I'm doing it backwards, but... Bottom floor, I want you to finish the alcohol, please. Kadi is up. Kadi, while he's doing alcohol, you can make meds. Not a bad day. Eventually. Alright, the alcohol is done. So now we just need to pick up the moonshine. Sleeping on the floor is terrible. Who told you to sleep on the floor? Did I screw up again? Occasionally it seems like I pick sleep instead of sleep on the bed. Y'all know because y'all watch the video replay, but... Alright, now I've rested. You get to make fuel from our wood. Roman gets the bait and trap. And Amelia, who I just flew past by accident, gets to keep making snowflakes. Things will work out eventually. Roman, you check her bullets. Vegetables should come due today. Okay, we have no casing, so we would need that. But you can maybe make another hatchet, because I don't want to run out. At last, something good happened. My sweet babies. Okay, Amelia, since you're done with that, let's get some more. Let's just get all the snowflakes. Get all of them. So I can just continue. A huge task. There's our snowman! Look how happy he looks! They can take our freedom, but they can never take our snowman. They probably could take our snowman, but they're not going to, and that's the important thing. Okay, so go until we're out of filters. You can go sit down if you like. Katia, we need more filters. Make those for us, please. So that's just gonna be our life. Filters and firewood and boiling water. And occasionally putting more stuff on the stove. Not a bad life. I feel like we're kind of rewarded for the fact that we got a lot of food early on. And that was what I was hoping, actually. I was hoping that a long 80-day haul with a late winter would mean that by time winter came, we would have so much food stockpiled that, and not just stockpiled, but also actually working in terms of replenishable food, that we would be able to not coast exactly, but just pay attention to, focus on water and fuel and such. Okay. I need 2 fertilizers, which will bring us to 6. And we've got... That would give us 4 vegetables to 3 meats. The extra fertilizer would be to make more herbs and also to make more rat traps. Alright, everybody's doing what they need to be doing. Good. So the only thing keeping us from more clean water is filters right now. We have filters, we're making more. First thing tomorrow, we need to load the vegetable. Alright. Zata may sleep in the bed. Roman will guard. Amelia will guard. Katia will scavenge. Back to the brothel. I'm not going to take an axe with me because there's a perfectly good axe that I left behind. The first half has already been emptied. The second half is where my mini pile is up there. Wow. That was, I assume, where he was keeping his trading stash. You don't know how to really reach that place, but that's fair. Sorry, the third half is where I'm keeping my mini stash. Not the most convenient to access place, but it kind of makes sense. Stop snowing. First floor is that wood, so let's go to the basement. Okay. Like, what if somebody just leaps out and locks me in down there? Nobody would do that.
And even if they did,
my friends would come save me. I'm really glad that, at least so far, there hasn't been any sense that your characters can be threatened with sexual violence. I like to, as much as possible, avoid that in games for reasons I've talked about elsewhere. I'm replaying Tomb Raider on the PS4 when I get a minute or two to myself recently, and that's maybe the one thing I don't like about an otherwise excellent game, is I do not like the sequence where it's a quick time event and you have to save her from being assaulted. I need a new hatchet. We have one of those at home. I actually got really triggered during that sequence because it was pretty rough. And it's funny, but it's really hard to successfully perform a quick time event when your hands are shaking so hard they can barely hold the controller. So that was not entertaining. But the rest of the game is great. I like the rest of the game a lot. It's got some problems racially, because there's a lot of what I would call Orientalism, but I like the overall game, if you can get past that. And you may not be able to. That's okay to not be able to. Okay, where was I? I want to take the moonshine and the jewelry to trade with Franco, because I feel like he's coming soon. Same with the tobacco. He pays really well for that, all things considered. More sugar will let me make more moonshine. Herbs, although I don't think that's enough to actually make anything. And coffee for my babies, because they need the coffee. So we're going to come back at least once, maybe twice. And I'm not even sure what I left in the pile by the front door. I suppose if I come back, I could spend some time running back and forth consolidating the two piles, but I kind of don't want to. I'm acutely aware of how many videos are in this Let's Play, and I'm actually feeling very guilty for dragging this out for so long. I'm not doing it on purpose, I swear. It's such a fine line to walk with, providing material but not boring everybody to tears. The night was calm. Do we even need guards anymore? I guess it doesn't hurt. Kadi, you get to go to bed. Roman, you get to eat some food and then go to bed. In your Roman bed. There you go. Amelia, I want you to take some food. And Zada, how about you put some kindling on the fire? We've got armchairs and a chair. Oh, well, they're at the top. Our shelter feels almost like home, giving us relief and helping us regain composure. We've got armchairs and a chair. We have beds and we sleep in decent conditions. If someone gets sick or wounded, they have a place to rest. We made a radio and we like listening to it. We've got a guitar and Zada can play it really well. Her music cheers us up in these hard times. We're glad to have many books. Reading helps forget the horrors of war. Staying here provides comfort in these hard times. We take 3 cigarettes a day, which is all Roman, and 2 cups of coffee today, which is 1 for Kadi and 1 for Amelia. All breaches in our walls have been boarded up. We have reinforced the door and installed an improvised alarm system. Even if we are caught sleeping, we should be able to repel most bandit attacks. And I don't even think they're trying anymore, given that everybody right now is staying inside, not freezing to death. So the radio isn't going to change. We can get started on some water. Actually, no, I don't want to do that because it would take my filters. Herbs are growing. There's nothing I can do to speed that up. Food. And we made it through the whole game so far without busting up the chair. Oh, we have no materials, so that's something to keep in mind for we could use some more materials for filters. Okay. We currently have not enough meat to make more meals than six. I'm making four. That's one day's worth. Hopefully Franco will show up soon. I miss him. Plus I just want to know he's okay. Okay. So yeah, we're going to use our filters on alcohol. Which is going to take some time. Well, if he follows his usual schedule of every third day, then I think he should be back on the 63rd. Day 63. Oh. Then again, here he is right now. Katia, go see. Go see Franco. Let's make a deal! Okay, you're gonna be really careful to click on the barter and not the X. Okay. Wow, he is. No, that's our stuff. Oh, I'm tired, apparently. Alright, let's take the bullets and the consumables and your moonshine and your books. We'll start there. And for that, I will give you a bandage and a meds, and the offer is just too darn impressive. Alright, deal with that. Deal with that. So I want all the things. Okay. I want all your materials for, what's the word I'm looking for? Filters. And for that, I will give you a diamond in the rough. And, wow, okay, no? Fine, we can have a deal. Oops, what am I doing? Alright, that'll do for now. And for that I will give you two alcohols. And I still have to make a few things. Katia, I need you to check down here. Do you know what we're not finding a lot of in the brothel, and this may be just be because we looted them all already, is we're not finding a lot of weapon parts. Like, to remake weapons. And like I said, we may have just got those all already. I don't mean the actual stacks of weapon parts that are kind of random things you put together, but oh my gosh, I forgot to get the vigil started. I am the worst. This is why I can't be trusted in survival situations, to be honest. It's only literally the most important thing. Make some medications for us. And meanwhile, Zlata is going to pick up the alcohol she just made, and Katia is going to pick up those herbs, And Amelia's gonna put fire on the fireplace. And Azalata's gonna make even more alcohol because we bought some moonshine to use. No rush, Kati. Don't feel the need to get a move on. I'm gonna make 5 more herbs. Amelia, you come down here. And Roman, you're on medication making duty. Because medications use things that we can't use. Katia, you go over here. Amelia, you keep working on that. And Katia, you're gonna go barter with the barter guy. So we're making a meds and we're making some more fresh alcohol, pure alcohol. So how can I buy everything you're carrying, Franco? Would you like a pistol? Would you like some bullets in the ground? Grounds that I don't think people are gonna keep coming back right now. Cigarettes. Tobacco. More cigarettes. I'm seriously thinking about selling most of my weapons, just because I'm not planning to kill anybody else from here and on in. I don't need to, I don't think so. And if I did, I'd be using a knife with Roman anyway. So, and people aren't coming to raid us. Oh, Zlata, I pressed the wrong button. I'm sorry, baby. Just mixing up everybody. Okay, let's try this again. So if I wanted to get those herbal meds, and say sold a lot of my alcohol, it's very generous of you. Well, I'm a generous person, Franco. Let's buy back the things I sold earlier. I'm not a good barterer. And I know that about myself. It's very generous of you. Fine, we can have a deal. Okay, so that was... I feel like that was a good deal. Those are all good things to have in winter. You can leave now, thank you. Obviously, I could have bartered better. I don't have any alcohol for bandages because I just sold it all, but that's fine because I don't have the herbs right now. And if I had the herbs, I'd make medications anyway. I don't want to make homegrown tobacco because that uses my medicinal herbs. And I see no reason to do those unless you really wanted to go trade with the soldiers. I'm gonna make a zillion cigarettes for Roman because I can. Which, yes, I realize that takes away from my supply of components for making filters, but I have a plan for that. The plan is top secret, but it basically involves getting more components for filters. Okay, so I have all the alcohol. I need to pick up my moonshine and potentially make more alcohol. I have a bunch of water, though. Like, I have one water. So I don't have a bunch of water at all. I actually need way more filters. That's fine. It's cool. Pure alcohol. And Amelia's gonna make the last of the filters and then make some more. Why did I think I had so much water? I probably did have more water before I used it all on the gardens. Because the vegetables took 20 and the herbs took another, what, 8 or 10? So yeah, I probably did have more. I just used it all. That's fine. That's what it's for. Amelia, once you're done with those, you get to go back to the snowflake pile. Who would have thought winter would be so busy? Not me. I'm literally just making 76 cigarettes because I want Roman to sort of be able to spread them all out on his bed and just sort of roll around in them, because I want him to have stress relief after all the many people I've forced him to kill. I feel bad about that. Roman can guard with his cigarettes. Roman can guard his cigarettes. Amelia can guard. Zlata can sleep in a bed. Katia can scavenge. Actually, you know what? Zlata can scavenge. Out to the brothel we go. And what is in this first pile? Stuff. Okay. Actual stuff. Alright. Now I think that we actually emptied everything out of this place. So at this point, it's just going through the piles. Is that what y'all think? I'm pretty sure. So now I just, I'll go ahead and consolidate them. How many runs will it take? It would take a lot of runs. We got nothing but time. It would probably honestly be easier to consolidate the first pile into the second, but we're committed to this idea now. I think what I want to do this time is take all the components so I can make filters and get water, because that's not a lot of matter. Leave the wood behind. Oh, okay. Now it's just a pile of wood, which I care so much less about. I'm not gonna consolidate sticks of wood. We just know, we'll take a note of it, that there's a special little hoard of wood up on the second floor over there. Okay. Take the armful of components, and we'll come back for everything. Friend egg. We really are. We're gonna spend at least, what, two more nights? Three more nights? At least scavenging this place. Okay, day 63. I don't think anyone's coming to fight, and I probably don't need to guard as obsessively as I am, but Slada can eat and go to bed. What are we doing on kindling? Not great. So that's another thing to bring back. Katia and Amelia are having their coffee. I don't know where Roman is. Katia is hungry, but she slept last night. Alright, Amelia. Off to bed, baby. Katia, you get to eat. And we have no water to make cooked food. In order to make water, we would need to use kindling. A second, let me finish my alcohol. What is that? 100% moonshine?
said. That bugs me.
I used to think that was moonshine, but... Oh, it's just... It's alcohol of any kind that you can drink, maybe? Now it's 10. Okay, so yeah, that is alcohol. Coming. Everybody else is sleeping. Yes. Hello. Hi. It's me again. Sorry to disturb you, but I'm terrified. It's me again. Yesterday, I saw a band of shady-looking types watching my house. I'm so scared. They might try to rob us, or worse. I have a teenage daughter. Can you please protect us for a night or two? You can use my husband's hunting shotgun. Okay, give me a second. I understand you need to think about it. No, I don't need to think about it. I want to send you someone who's actually competent with a shotgun. He's not going to be happy about going, but that's his own lookout. He's not going to be happy about going at all. Filters. Roman, I know you're not going to like this. Finish sleeping and then you're going. Zoom out. Keep an eye on everybody. I predict Zlotta will be the first one up. Yes, we'll help you. Just give me a second. We're still sleeping. I don't want to send Katia or Amelia or Zlotta. I don't even know if they know how to use a shotgun. Alright, no, 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 no. What are you doing? Zlotta, you get to come down here and double check my still. Which I'm pretty sure you can't put anything in because I'm pretty sure we're out of sugar. Yeah, we're out of sugar. Cigarettes. Which, I mean, Roman can take with him. He's welcome to take as many cigarettes as he wants. Alright, Roman. I know you're not gonna like this, but I need you to go take care of people who need more help than we do. People who need help more than we do. And now Amelia, you can put some more wood on the fire. Actually, how is our kindling situation? No, don't put wood on the fire. Make water for me instead. Yesterday, I saw a band of shady-looking types watching my house. I'm so scared they might try to rob us or worse. I have a teenage daughter. Can you please protect us for a night or two? You can use my husband's shotgun. Yes. I know Roman's not going to be happy. But, I mean, it's just... just how it is. Make water. I'm not sure helping our neighbor is worth the risk. Oh, Amelia. I feared we might not agree to help our neighbor in need. I'm glad we did. We couldn't just leave our neighbor in need. She was terrified. I mean, honestly, if I had my druthers, I would rather they pack up and come here. Because... this place is safer, and I feel like that would be a better thing for everybody, but no, I'm not going to turn her away like, no, sorry, not interested. Oh yeah, I forgot I have wood. I gotta make kindling that way. Dumb. Okay. Rather chilly inside, we should think about heating. Yeah. Okay, Zlotta, you can go get... you can go put wood in the fireplace. I don't like... it's like it doesn't even count unless it's a full six. Which is frustrating. It's funny that the party that you pick, it really does... like... if you pick a bunch of people who are very compassionate, then I wonder if they'll get along better in terms of being content when they help neighbors and stuff, than if you pick a bunch of people who are a little bit more self-oriented and potentially, you know, I mean, like Amelia is actually kind of annoyed when we help people. And I feel bad for her because I know that she's been hurt badly. She's already talked about how, you know, her father and sister were brutally murdered. So, you know, obviously she's kind of closed off emotionally a little bit. And that's understandable. I don't blame her for it. That would take an hour. But we don't have an hour, so I'm just gonna sit here and wait. Alright, end day. Emilia's gonna guard all by herself. Kadi is gonna, or Zla's gonna scavenge, and Kadi can sleep in bed. Excuse me. I try not to belch into the microphone. That seems unprofessional and gross. But I'm drinking a soda, and sometimes these things happen. Alright, I want all that kindling. And I want that water. And I want that meat. And I want... No, I don't want those parts. What am I doing? I want those cigarettes. Which don't stack as nearly as well as I thought. Oh, no, they do. Okay. And I still feel like if they come back right away, you should get some kind of not as tired as they could be bonus or something. I'm greedy. Cold days have passed. Diary, we have wintered. Winter's over? Dude, I just picked up a zillion kindlings. Winter lasted like 3 days? Roman brought back some gun ammo. I just brought back a zillion kindlings. What am I gonna do with all that? okay. That's something. I guess we're back to rainwater. I'm glad I did. I seriously considered chopping the rainwater thingies up for kindling, and because I thought they wouldn't be usable for the rest of the game. So I'm glad I didn't do that. Wait, do we still have snowflakes in our inventory? We do, so we can still boil the snowflakes. Okay, I'm gonna do that. Okay, Zlata, you can go up to bed. Kadia, you can go get some food. Roman, you can get food after Kadia.
Aw, bloody heck, we can't boil the- that is not fair.
So we still have the snowflakes in our inventory, but we can't boil them, even though we spent all that time getting them and getting kindling. I don't like that. I don't like that. That doesn't feel fair to me. You should have at least a day to like a warning to boil your snowflakes before they all melt. I am irked. And it's silly because it's a silly thing to be irked about, but I have like 22 snowflakes in my inventory and no way to melt them. That's silly. I should be allowed to boil them briefly. That's a filter and it's going. That's a moonshine and it can't go because I have no sugar. The two vegetable gardens are going. That's another water filter and it's going. So I can either be making more filters, which I can't actually because I have no materials, or I can be making cigarettes just to pass the time. Oh, that irks me. I am irked. This is my irked face. And oh, we're out of vegetables, partly because I screwed up and waited so long to plant them, and partly because Franco didn't ever bring any for us to buy. So tomorrow we would have to dip into our canned food supply. Our canned food. Let's turn this canned food into canned food. Sorry, I'm really quite garbage. At last something good happened. And we don't have to keep filling the heater. Patty, why don't you go start another filter here? And another filter here. Soon it will be over and we'll be fine. We're gonna take some of these cigarettes to go trade. Except I think they're valueless. I think they're worth more as raw tobacco than as cigarettes, which in of itself is... Although, that actually may not be true, because they make more than one, it's not a one-to-one relationship. And we ran into that with some of the other things we can make in barter. Okay. I would like to go back to the brothel for components, but twist surprise, the brothel doesn't have components. I mean, put all that work into that snowman, too. I wanted that to be like our ceasefire snowman. Amelia, you might as well sit down. I don't have anything for you to do. All I really have to do is wait for these to finish, but I kind of don't want to. Let's zip forward. Shoom! Alright, Roman, you can guard. Amelia, you can guard. Patty, you can sleep in bed. Zlata, you can scavenge. And I think this is our last brothel visit. We certainly don't need to go back for wood. And tomorrow's going to be interesting because I have no vegetables. So we dip into our canned food supply. Okay. The brothel officially only has wood. I have taken a note of it. And now we have to decide how to spend the next 15 days. Night was calm. Alright, you can go to bed. Roman can go to bed. I want you on the herbs. And I need you to make a fertilizer. Well, Amelia, stop drinking your coffee and go to bed. We're gonna make it. Rats are fine. We have no components, so I can't make anything at the component desk. I have filters and could be making water, so we'll do that next. And then I think I'll cut this video because it's getting kind of long. Basically, the next thing we need to figure out is where we want to go tonight. Open up, I brought things for barter. Good. That makes a difference. I'm hoping he brought vegetables. I haven't dipped into the canned food just yet. I know it's silly, I don't want to eat the canned food unless I absolutely have to. Just a minute, just getting some water going. And we are going to have a vegetable harvest today. We just have to wait for it. So we could make dinner then. We need food. Yeah, I know you do. Yeah, I'm hungry. And there's some harvest down there. So grab that real quick. They can also eat raw food, but it's not as nutritious. They have to eat like 2 raw food to 1 canned food. Okay. All right, Katia, make me proud. Part of the pants off of Franco. And the backpack. He brought 1 vegetable. It's a start. It's a start. Ooh, and I sold all my guns thinking, oh, well, nobody will ever raid us again because it's perpetual winter forever. And it turns out it wasn't. Lots of materials, though. That's nice. All right, what can we sell you? How about a broken guitar? I don't want to sell any of my weapons. I don't want to sell my consumables or my books. Do you want some snowflakes? The alcohol is potentially useful, but we might sell it. What about one of my hatchets? How do you feel about cigarettes? Nothing special, but not bad either. Whoa, that got generous real fast. Fine, we can have a deal. Okay, let's have a deal. I want all your wood. Seven. Okay. Fine, we have a deal. I don't want the hatchet or the lock picks. I do want those herbs very badly. The meat and the tobacco would be nice to have. The coffee would be wonderful to have. How about 1 meds, 2 meds, and some cigarettes? No, he doesn't like that. All right. Quality food. It's just interesting. They're like flavored tobacco. Okay. So what do you have left? You have the guitar I sold you, the hatchet I don't want, the lockpicks I don't need, the cigarettes I sold you, and then bandages and herbal meds, which would be nice to have, but I have nothing worth selling you for them. So you might as well go, but thank you very much. We have just enough vegetables to make 1 super soup, which I will make just so Katia has food. Then you get to go downstairs and start making filters. Roman, you get to eat and then make cigarettes. Zlata, I want you to hover over the vegetable table. And Amelia, you can hover somewhere else. 10 filters, and I'll have 20. Alright. Oh, Amelia, I want you to be putting filters in. That's what I want. Okay, so that's how we'll spend the rest of the day. Roman's gonna make cigarettes, of which he has a few left. Amelia's gonna make. Gonna put in filters, and Zlata is watching the vegetables like a hawk. Zoom out very slightly. We have a plan. Unfortunately, I have. poker fingers. Here we go. Make some ads. I would really like to get some sugar for some more moonshine, for some more bandages. And of course some food. Is it worth going back to the garage where the older man and his son lived? They wanted bandages, and I think they had food. Hey, where are you going? Coleman just walk off? He's going to go enjoy his cigarettes, I guess. We'll make one fertilizer from the vegetables, and one fertilizer from the meat. Yeah, he's gonna go smoke. Maybe you can make dinner for you and Slotta. Alright, everybody hurry so y'all can eat before you go to bed. That's important. It's good to have the water filters going again. I kind of miss the snow because I had all the kindling, but it's fine. We would need more pills, med ingredients, and we would need components to make bandages. That's fine. I think the garage actually had components, but I'm not sure. I might have just left it down to, stripped it down to wood. All right, Amelia, you get a meal, and then you can go sit down. Zlata, you get a meal. We got everybody fed before nighttime. Awesome. Look at that. Okay, so that was the smoke is what I need. Good. I'm glad you're happy, Roman. I really am. Even if you never actually do get content. I'm going to cut the end of the video here, and then we're going to pick up in the next video, and we are getting so close to the end. I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.